Dear friends, in class 7 we are studying lines and angles, and next point is linear pair. Try to understand the angles in linear pair. Here these are adjacent angles. Linear pair angles in linear pair are always adjacent angles, and non-common arms are opposite rays. For this, let's understand the opposite rays. If two rays start from the same vertex, from the same starting point, but if the direction is opposite, so if this is OA starting from O vertex and this is OB starting from O vertex only, then ray OA and ray OB are opposite rays. This is what we have already studied. If two rays are having completely opposite direction and start from a common vertex, then they are said to be opposite rays. Please note, together they form a line. So these opposite rays OA and OB together form a line. So such rays which start from same vertex and in opposite direction are said to be opposite rays. Now see, a pair of adjacent angles. Here two angles must be adjacent angles whose non-common arms are opposite rays. So here angle A and angle B, you will see, have a common vertex. So they must have a common vertex. That means they must be adjacent angles. They do have a common arm, and their non-common arms are on opposite sides of the common arm. So these angles are adjacent angles. So here they must be adjacent angles, and they are adjacent angles. But one more condition is attached to this. Here ray non-common arms must be opposite rays. That is, they together must form a line. Or this can be read as if a ray stands on a line. Here this can be read something like this. Here ray OC stands on the line AB or BA. Ray OC stands on the line BA. So these two angles are said to be angles in linear pair. Again, remember the words. They must be adjacent angles, and the non-common arms must be the opposite rays. So these conditions must be fulfilled. Then and then only we can call two angles as angles in linear pair. Please note, the sum of the measures of angles in linear pair is always 180 degrees. If you measure the total sum, or if you do the addition of this angle plus this angle, A plus B, you will notice that measure of the angle A plus measure of the angle B is always 180 degrees. It means angles in linear pair are always supplementary. Dear friends, let us try to understand angles in linear pair with some more questions and some more figures. Here, first question is, can two acute angles form a linear pair? So try to understand. Acute angles means the angles having their measure less than 90 degrees. So if one is 45 degrees and other angle is also 45 degrees, or if one is 45 and other is 45, these rays cannot be opposite rays. Please try to understand. If you take even 89 degrees and 89 degrees, then also you will notice that they don't form a linear. They don't form, these two rays cannot form opposite rays. So if two angles are acute angles, they cannot form a linear pair. So we can say that two acute angles can never form linear pair. Two acute angles can never form a linear pair. They can never form a linear pair. Now let us try to understand with the help of second question as well. Can two obtuse angles, if both angles are greater than 90 degrees, if this is 100 degrees and one more angle is 100 degrees, again you will notice that these non-common rays are not opposite rays. So they cannot form a linear pair. One more thing, we have already said that angles in linear pair are supplementary. So if this is 91 degrees and other is 91 degrees, means they are obtuse angles. We know that obtuse angles have their measures more than 90 degrees. So here 91 degrees plus 91 degrees is 182 degrees. It means they are not supplementary. Hence two obtuse angles can never form a linear pair. Then can two right angles form a linear pair? Let us try to understand. Here this angle is 90 degree and the other angle is also 90 degrees. So you will notice that if two angles have right angles, then the non-common arms are opposite rays. They are always forming a opposite rays. So two right angles always form a linear pair. Two adjacent right angles always form a linear pair. Dear friends, let us try to understand linear pair with some more figures. Check which of the following pairs of angles form a linear pair. We have already studied that linear pair, angles in linear pair must be adjacent angle. It means they must have a common vertex, they must have a common arm, and the non-common arms must be on opposite side of the common arm. This is what are the conditions for the adjacent angles. They must be adjacent angles. Then another condition is the non-common arms must be opposite rays. This is extra, one more condition which is necessary for angles in linear pair. So let us try to check whether these angles form a linear pair. Now see, here angle 40 degrees and 140 degrees. So please note, here they do have a common vertex, they do have a common arm, and non-common arms are on opposite side of the common arm. So they are adjacent angles. So these two angles are adjacent angles, and these 40 and 140, 40 plus 140 is 180 degrees. So major is 180 degrees. We have already studied angles in linear pair are supplementary. So these angles fulfill all the necessary conditions. So these angles form a linear pair. So it is angles are in linear pair. Now let us understand the second figure. Here one measure is given to us as 60 degree, other is 90 degree. If you add 60 plus 90, that is equal to 150 degrees. This is not equal to 180 degrees. Means these two angles are not supplementary. Please note, here they do have a common vertex, they do have a common arm, they are adjacent angles, but the non-common arms don't form an opposite rays. These rays are not opposite rays. Their measure is only 150 degrees. So these two angles are not linear pair, not in linear pair, not forming a linear pair. Let us understand with the third figure. Now we are given one angle as 90 degree, other angle as 80 degrees. Please try to understand. We have already said in definition the pair of adjacent angles. So these two angles are separate angles. They don't have a common vertex, they don't have a common arm, and hence these angles are not adjacent angles. And since they are not adjacent angles, they are not forming a linear pair. So these angles don't form linear pair. These angles don't form a linear pair. Then next is fourth pair. Let us try to understand. Here 65 plus 115 is equal to 5 plus 5 is 0, 10, 1 carries. Then 6 plus 2, 8, 180 degrees. So it means their addition is 180 degrees. We have already said angles in linear pair are supplementary. They are supplementary, so they must be in linear pair. One more thing we need to understand, whether they do have a common vertex, so they do have a common vertex, then they do have a common arm, and the non-common arms are on opposite side. It means these two angles are adjacent angles. So as they form adjacent angles, as well as their sum is 180 degrees, means the non-common arms are forming opposite rays. So since these rays are opposite, these angles form linear pair. So angles form linear pair. Angles form a linear pair.